these two questions, 12 and 13 questions, are very important questions. Okay, so all these questions are advanced levels. Okay, keep in your mind. So this is the cylindrical vessel. Its diameter is 2h and the height is 3h. Now there is a rod of height h which is keeping vertically to the vertical wall of the cylinder shown in the diagram, keeping like this. So observer I is keeping at the edge. This is the position of the eye of the observer. He is able to see the top end of the rod. He is unable to see the remaining portion. He is only see the top end of the rod. Now the question is, he wants to see the bottom portion of the rod without changing his eye position. Eye position keeping at the same position, but he wants to see the bottom portion of this vertical rod, for which a liquid is poured in it. To what level? To a level of 2H. Liquid is poured in it to a height 2H. Then he can able to see this bottom portion of the rod. Then what will be the refractive index of this liquid poured in this vessel? This is question. Okay, now initially he is observing the top of the rod without changing the eye position. He wants to see the bottom end of the rod, for which a liquid is poured in this vessel to a height of 2h. Then what will be the refractive index of this liquid? Right, so whenever the liquid is poured up to here, at the beginning when height is h, height of the rod is h, so up to this level remove this part and think of this remaining. So total 3H from which H is removed, the remaining will be 2H here. This is 2H and this is 2H. 2H, 2H. From this triangle, so adjacent side, opposite side, both are equal. In such case, your angle is 45 degrees. Very clear? 45 degrees. Now, the liquid is poured in it to a height of 2H. Then this ray will be refracted, and the refracted ray will start from here. This is a refracted ray and undergoes here. A normal is drawn at this point. Normal is drawn. So from here the light is traveling from liquid into, this is liquid into air medium. So it bends away from normal. Of course this angle 45 degree, this is also 45 degree. At right angles. Okay. Now the bottom portion is, in order to see this bottom portion, then light must start from here and it is traveling from this point in the liquid and entering into air medium. It bends away, denser into rarer, bends away from normal. Is it clear? Now this is, this height is 2H, already given at 2H, and from here to here it is H. This is a H, this is 2H. From this triangle, this is 2H, this is H, this is root 5H. So this angle is taken to be angle of incidence, this is angle is angle of refraction. So angle of incidence I here. Okay, from this sin I is equal to how much? Sin I is equal to opposite side H by root 5H. HH gets cancelled, sin I is equal to how much? 1 by root 5. Now sin R is equal to, sin R is equal to, that is sin R, sin 45 R is equal to, which is giving 1 by root 2. Therefore using Snell's law, refractive index of liquid is equal to sin R by, means liquid refractive index mu and sin of the angle in the same medium. Sin I is equal to outside the refractive index 1, because air medium, sin R. Therefore mu is equal to sin R by sin I. mu is equal to sin r 1 by root 2, sin r equal to 1 by root 2 by sin a 1 by root 5. So which gives by simplifying the refractive index of liquid root over 5 by 2. This is your answer. Okay, next go for another problem, problem number 13. Okay, now in this case it is cylindrical vessel again. Its diameter and the height both are equal, each 30 centimeters. Diameter is 30 centimeters, height is also 30 centimeters. Okay, now eye of observer is keeping at the edge of the vessel. See here, this is eye position of the observer, and from here observer can able to see the corner of this vessel. Means up to this corner only he can see, this end up to here he can see, up to this level, and beyond this he cannot be seen. He is not able to see this portion and everything, so only he can see this portion up to here. Okay, so he can see up to the corner of the vessel, and beyond this he is not able to see this portion. Okay, so at the beginning, now without changing the eye position of this observer, he should not change his position, eye position, but he wants to see the point P. P is at a distance of 5 cm from center of the vessel. He wants to see this point P, for which he used the logic that refraction concept is adopted, for which the water is poured in this vessel to certain height, such that due to refraction, so he will see this point P. Means the water is poured in the vessel. Water is poured in the vessel to a certain height, such that he can able to see the point P, which is on the horizontal surface, or which is on the bottom of the cylindrical vessel at a distance of 5 cm from its center. And P is point on the plane of drawing, means horizontal surface. Okay, so this is the point. So what is the question here? To what height the water is to be poured in the vessel in order to see this point P? Okay, now so water is taken in it up to certain level. Beginning, at the beginning first we decide that this is 30, this is 30, adjacent and opposite sides are equal, therefore what is the angle over here? This is 45 degree. Clear? Now water is poured in it up to certain height, right? So this is level of water taken in the vessel H. Whenever water is taken here, the light is, suppose when he see this point P, the condition is in order to see the point P, so light must start from point P, and that light is traveling in the water from point P. Next, here normal is drawn at this point of incidence. Then what happens here? The light is traveling in the water, and at the boundary it bends away from the normal, because so light is traveling from denser into rarer. Water is denser, air is rarer, its refractive index is 1. So here 45 degree, it is also 45 degree. This is angle of refraction. Angle of incidence is here, I is angle of incidence. Okay, clear? Now this is 5 centimeters, of course. So this is 45. Therefore, this portion is H. Remaining this one is 30 minus H. Because of 45 angle, this side is 30 minus H. Definitely, this opposite side is also 30 minus H. Therefore, this portion will be 30 minus H. Okay, now from center to the edge, what is this distance? Total 30. This is 15. From 15, 5 is removed off. Remaining will be here 10 centimeters. See here, I want to find this side. Say this is A, this is B, and this is point P. This is point P. So from this triangle, I want to find PB. PB. PB is equal to, see here, PB is equal to, PB is equal to total 30 minus this portion and this portion. These two are subtracted from 30, you will get PB. Therefore, 30 minus H, next, plus 10. So, this 10 and 30 minus H totally. Yeah, next, go for example 14. Here there is a concave mirror of focal length 10 centimeters. And an object is keeping at a distance of 30 centimeters and its corresponding image formed at a distance of 15 centimeters, which is the real image, 15 centimeters, at which the image is formed. This is object, this is image. So this data is given in the problem. Once again, there is a concave mirror of focal length 10 centimeters and an object is keeping at a distance of 30 centimeters, its corresponding real image is formed at a distance of 15 centimeters, shown in figure 1. Okay, next, in figure 2, whenever a glass plate of thickness 3 centimeters and refractive index is 1.5, 3 by 2 is introduced between object and the concave mirror in figure 2. Then the image, in order to form the image at the same location at 15 centimeter distance from this concave mirror, so to what distance the object is to be shifted in order to get the image position will be at the same 15 centimeters from the concave mirror. Once again, I repeat the question. So, before introducing the glass plate, image formed 15 centimeter distance. Object is at 30 centimeters. Okay. After introducing the glass plate, image should be at same distance 15 centimeters for which object must be shifted from its original place. Then what is the shifting is to be taken for the object in order to get the image at the same location. This is the question. Yes. So in this case, when the glass plate is introduced, so let us take the mirror is to be shifted by how much? When we consider observer is observing the mirror from this side, then the mirror is to be shifted by certain amount. Then shift of the mirror can be found by using apparent depth concept or apparent shift concept. So apparent shift is, see here, whenever the mirror is shifted from its original position, this is original position. So mirror is shifted, that is yes, shifting. Object is here. So from original mirror, object distance is 30 actually. Now, sorry, image distance. We go for image. Here image distance actually from the mirror position, image distance is 15 centimeters. From original mirror. This is the apparent position of the mirror. Apparent position. From this apparent position, image is at what distance, which is taken to be V dash. Okay, once again go for the data. Here, image distance V is, see, then we consider V is equal to UF by U minus F. By substituting the values, U is minus 30 into F minus 10 by minus 30 minus or minus plus 10. So this is 300 by how much? Minus 20, which gives us minus 15 centimeters. Yes. So image formed at a distance of minus 15 means real image is formed. Negative sign representing that real image is formed on the same side as that of the object. But in this case, so for this situation, image should be at the same place. So object should be shifted by certain amount. So what should be the shifting of the object in order to get the position of the image will be same from the mirror. Okay. Right, for that, whenever we are taking the shifting of the mirror, because when the glass plate is introduced, then glass plate due to which the refraction takes place, the mirror is to be shifted forward. The shifting of the mirror is calculated. How much? Let us find the shift of the mirror. This is equal to T of 1 minus 1 by mu glass. Yes. S is equal to shift is T equal to how much? 3. 1 minus. This is 2 by 3. And by simplifying this, so you will get 1 centimeter is the shift. Once you are taking the shift of the mirror, then glass plate is to be removed off. So its meaning is, in order to remove this glass plate in between the object and the mirror, then we have to take the shifting of the mirror to apparent position. To the apparent position. Once you are taking the apparent position of the spherical mirror or concave mirror, then the glass plate is to be removed. Since its duty is over, its role is over, the glass plate is giving its role, the shift of, apparent shift of the image, sorry, apparent shift of the concave mirror or any object or concave mirror. So concave mirror is shifted because of the glass plate. Once it is shifted, its role is over. Remove the glass plate. Yes, glass plate is removed. Now the image is at a distance of 15 centimeters from the original mirror, but shift is 1 centimeter forward. Therefore, now final image position is 14 centimeters. Why? Because 15 minus 1 from apparent position, it is of 14 centimeter distance. So this is, so image distance. Then what is the distance of object? Focal length is minus 10 centimeters. By taking the sign convention, minus. So let us find object distance by using this data. So 1 by V dash minus, sorry, plus 1 by U dash is equal to 1 by F. U dash, let us find U dash how much? 1 by V dash minus 14 plus of minus, or otherwise we are finding U dash, no need to use sign convention for it, is equal to 1 by minus 10. Okay. Now, 1 by U dash is equal to 1 by 14 minus 1 by 10. Okay. Simplify this. 10 minus 14 by 140, which gives us 140. That is minus 140 by 4 remaining. This gives us 35 centimeters. Now object position is 35 centimeters. From where? From apparent position to object distance. This is say object. So object position is 35 centimeters from apparent position of the concave mirror. Yes, from original mirror, what is the distance of object? From original mirror, 1 centimeter is add up, total 36 centimeters. So that is the 36 centimeters where the object is kept. Then its corresponding image will be formed at the same distance 15 centimeters from the original radar, so whenever the glass plate is introduced. Now let us verify the object position initially 30. Now how much? 35 plus 1 original mirror from original mirror, 36. So 36 minus 30 centimeters, which is giving shift of the object S dash, shift of the object 6 centimeters. So whenever the object is shifted by 6 centimeters, so image will be formed at the same place at a distance of 15 centimeters. So this is the a very important question in the logical. It depends on so shifting, apparent shift of the object and also mirror combination. It is mixed concept. Okay, then let us move on. Another problem. The problem is given. It is composite slabs 1, 2, 3. Three different mediums. Three different medium, which is composite slabs having different materials. Their refractive indices are mentioned 1.5, 1, second one, third is 1.5. Okay? And the system is keeping in front of a concave mirror at a distance of 10 centimeters. At a distance of 10 centimeters. Okay? Now, object is keeping at a distance of, object position is given 20 centimeters from this slab. Okay, now as a whole the system is submerged in water. The radius of curvature of the concave mirror is 150 centimeters. Then find the position of the image of this object formed due to glass plates, sorry, due to different media or composite slabs and also mirror together. Once again, there is a concave mirror of radius of curvature 150 centimeters, a composite slabs 1, 2, 3 are of different materials are keeping at a distance of 10 centimeters from the concave mirror, and object is keeping at a distance 20 centimeters from the first plate, and as a whole total system is submerged in water. Then find the position of the image of this object due to the composite slabs and also by the concave mirror. Okay, let us find that. See, here, again, same, we are going to find the position of the object. Position of the object. So, position of the object due to refraction, shifting, everything. So, here, it is incident medium, already this concept is given. Incident medium. This is observed medium. Mirror is in observed medium where the light is going to be reflected and giving its corresponding image by the concave mirror. Therefore, this medium and this medium both are same. Therefore, this 20 centimeters, this 10 centimeters, these two media same. Therefore, straight away, we consider this one as distance of object directly. Distance of the object is, that is 20 centimeters plus 10 centimeters. This is 20 and this is 10. And next one is apparent position plus T1 by mu 1 means mu glass with respect to water. Because the total system submerged in water plus T2 by mu glass with respect to water plus T3 by mu glass with respect to water. Three glass plates are there and this medium same. This is water, 20 and 10. So we are calculating that apparent position. Apparent position of the object from the mirror. So as a whole this system is in water. Therefore we are calculating the image position in the water. Therefore we are not calculating in outside air. We are not calculating the position of the image in the air and position of the object in the air. We are calculating in the water itself. Therefore here it is 20 centimeters, it is also 10 centimeters other side, and this is with respect to water we are calculating, this is 20 plus 10, 30 plus, this is the first one is the thickness 54 centimeters by mu glass 3 by 2 relative refractiveness 4 by 3 plus second one is 24 by 3 by 2 by 4 by 3 plus here, sorry, its refractive index is given 1.5, 3 by 2, it is correct, 3 by 2 by 4 by 3, this is 1 only, this is 1, and the third one is, its thickness is given 45 centimeters by relative refraction 1.5 and 1.5 means 3 by 2 by 4 by 3, right, so 30, this is apparent position of the object due to refraction of the composite slabs and water together, therefore it is u dash object distance indirectly from the concave mirror plus this is giving 54 by 9 by 8, 8 comes up plus 24 by, this is reciprocal, so how much this, so 3 by 4 plus 45 into, so this is 9 by 8, which is this is 9, 8 by, of course it is the reciprocal, how much this, 9 by 8 into 8, okay, now simplify this, 36 6 5 plus 48 plus 18 plus 40. So simplifying this, you will get 150 centimeters. Now in water, object distance from this concave mirror is 150 centimeters. What is the radius of curvature of the concave mirror? 150. Therefore, it is of 150 centimeters and the object distance is also 150. What does it mean? There is a concave mirror. Its radius of curvature 150 centimeters. Object is keeping exactly at center of curvature 150 centimeters. Then image will also found at the same position. So question is asking that, what is the position of the image formed by the total system? The image position will be at the same 150 centimeters, which is formed at the center of curvature, because apparent position of the object is 150 at center of curvature. Therefore, image is also formed at the same position. Therefore, answer is 150 centimeters. Okay? Next, let us go for another question. Yeah, next go for another problem, example 16. So in this case, there are three different materials or material, different slabs of different materials. There are three different sizes and sizes of the glass plates are different materials. Okay, now this slab is of thickness 0.1 centimeter, this slab is size of 0.3 centimeters, and this is having 0.4 centimeters. Now, in this problem, gap is left between two successive slabs, and their refractive indices are given. It is 1.4, its refractive index 1.3, and it is of 1.2. So these are the different refractive indices of different materials, which are parallel sided slabs, and the gap is left between two successive is 1 centimeter 1 centimeter, and a point object P is kept at a distance of 1 centimeter from this slab. So find the position of this object when seen from this position. So what is the position of this object? Object is at point P. So what is its position when seen from above? Right. It's a very important question. So generally we calculate this point for apparent depth is calculated, and by this apparent depth, by this apparent depth, again 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, all are calculated, but it is wrong. We never go for that kind of method. Actually, this is incident medium concept. This is incident medium, this is observed medium. Incident and observed medium is same. And between the two successive glass plates, medium is also same everywhere. Therefore, a very, very important point is when incident and observer mediums are same. So this distance of the object would not be influenced the final position of the image when seen from above. So this point already we discussed. Therefore, no need to take this position of the object at anywhere, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeters, or 5 centimeters, anywhere else. That never we depend on distance. Why? Because the incident medium and the observer medium is same. Therefore, in this case, apparent depth straight away. Apparent depth. So apparent depth is how much? T dash equal to T1 by mu1 plus T2 by mu2 plus T3 by mu3. Right? Substitute the values. Here T1 is 1.4 by, sorry, T1 is 0.4 by 1.4 plus 0.3 by 1.3 plus 0.2 by 0.1. Once again, see, this is a refractive index. Here its thickness 0.4, 0.4 by 1.4, 0.3 by 1.3, here 0.1, sorry, 0.1 by, here it is, 1.2. By simplifying this, you would get nearly of 0.59, that is roughly of 0.6 centimeters. This is the apparent depth of the object which is kept at point P. So if you want to find the shift, apparent shift, very simple. In order to find the shifting, this thickness, total how much? 0.1, 0.3, 0.4. 0.4 plus 0.3 plus 0.1. Total thickness means total depth minus apparent depth 0.6. How much this? 0.7, 0.8. 0.8 minus 0.6, which gives us 0.2 centimeters. This is the apparent shift of this object whenever seen from above. Why we are taking like this? So, incident medium, observer medium, and between two successive slabs, the medium will be same everywhere. Therefore, the separation is independent of shift of the image. Therefore, directly we can take this thickness, its thickness, total minus apparent depth calculated 0.6. So, by subtracting this, you will get 0.2 centimeters. Okay? Next, let us go for another problem. This portion removed from 30. Therefore, remaining will be 30 minus. So, what is this value? 30 minus h plus 10. Total it is of, directly we can take the 40 minus h. Simplify this, h minus 10. So, this is a h minus 10. And take this right angle triangle over here. This is a right angle triangle. This is B. This is how much? H. And this portion is H minus 10. And this is angle of incidence I. Okay? So, let us remove this portion. Next, this is opposite side, this is addition. From this, tan I is equal to how much? Tan I is equal to h minus 10 by h. Keep it aside, equation 1. Tan I. Okay? And already refractive index of this liquid is given. Therefore, using Snell's law, refractive index of water is equal to water into sin I in the same medium. Sin I using Snell's law, that equal to 1 refractive index air medium sin 45. Therefore, sin I is equal to sin 45 1 by root 2 and by mu water, which gives us 1 by root 2 and 4 by 3 means 3 by 4 root 3. Okay, from this sin I we can find, remove this one and go for next for the solution. Sin I means, okay, now in this case here up to this point it's over, the next going here for making a triangle, right angle triangle, sin I is equal to opposite side 3 and hypotenuse 4 root 2, then this adjacent side that becomes root 23. So from the same triangle tan I is considered 3 by root 23 is equation 2, equating 1 and 2, equations 1 and 2, equating them, then h minus 10 by h is equal to 3 by root 23. So after solving this, when you solve this, you will get h is equal to 26.6 centimeters. So this is the way to find the height of the water poured in this vessel in order to see the point P in the vessel, which is marked at the bottom of the vessel. And as the level increases in this water, then this slowly moving beyond this point P. We can also see the point C when the level slowly increases. So as the level decreases, so that will be shifting slowly up to the corner. Total it is empty, then corner will be seen by the observer. So whenever the water is poured, slowly it is by the refraction. So this is slowly shifting to the center of the vessel. So this is all about this question number 13. Okay, thank you. Entendi?